I got fresh ground coffee to start my day, and I want a Camaro. What can I say?
Want to keep an eye on your money? Now there are three great places to get the best in financial news. On CBS Television, CBS Radio, and on the web at cbs.marketwatch.com. Follow your portfolio, and when you're ready, trades are just a click away. CBS News, your eye on the market.
Here's your Friday forecast. The latest satellite picture shows the skies have cleared up over most of the east, which is not a good sign for the weekend. It's still gray and stormy across the Ohio Valley and the plains, and it's also been very stormy around the southern and central Rockies. You might think it's October later today around Denver, where it will be windy and wet with temperatures that may not even get out of the 50s. I'm told up in July, the northwest will bake in 95 to 100 degrees heat. Widespread showers and thunderstorms will be found on the Tennessee Valley. Much of the east coast and these storms are going to hang around for a while in the east, where many flood watches are being posted. The Great Lakes Midwest will have a gorgeous weekend featuring chilly nights and pleasant afternoons with deep blue skies. It's the end of an era for Bell. AT&T says it will no longer solicit new customers for residential phone service because it can't compete with the old baby Bell. AT&T will now concentrate on business customers. Stock prices are lower this morning across the Pacific Rim, mainly on a lack of fresh news to move them higher. Alexis Christopher is on the CBS Market Watch.
It's a big week for Microsoft. After the closing bell, the software giant reported an 81% surge in profits on strong sales of its Office software program. Profits were still a penny shy of estimates. Just a few days ago, Microsoft said it plans to return more than $75 billion to shareholders over the next 4 years. It plans to do that through a combination of stock buyback and higher dividend. Also after the closing bell, Amazon.com posted its fourth straight quarterly profit thanks to strong international sales, but the online retailer's profits were a penny shy of estimates. And Coca-Cola said profits bubbled up 16% in its second quarter thanks in part to strong sales of its diet drinks. Although sales at Coke saw their smallest gain in about 2 years. On Wall Street, after a roller coaster day, stocks finished nearly unchanged. The Dow Jones Industrial Average inching up 4 points. The Nasdaq Composite added nearly 15. A big beer merger could go flat. U.S.-based Ingles Coors and Canadian-based brewer Molson agreed to merge in a $3.4 billion stock swap. If approved, it would create the fifth biggest brewer in the country. But some shareholders don't support the deal, and Ian Molson, who is feuding with family members over the merger, may threaten a counterbid. You can stay on top of your stocks and all the day's business news at cbs.marketwatch.com. In New York, I'm Alexis Christophorus.